War. War never changes. Since the dawn of man, when tribes beat each other to death over necessities, the will to power has been the driving force of mankind. When the great fires of humanity's ambition ravaged the earth, it was not our doing. For the bloodiest chapter of human history had only begun. Britain was not spared the hellfire. And London, a monument to mankind's ambition, was returned to the state of nature. Those who emerged from the ashes did so from a network of underground bunkers known as Pindar stations. And so it was that the embers of civilization would ignite once again. Over a century later, through the military might of the Tommies, an aristocratic parliament continues to give orders. But few are still listening. In the Tower Hamlets, the fifth column rises. Training drums beat and uniforms march, all in the name of their dear leader, Eve Varney. Across the Thames, in the pastures of Richmond, a great army gathers strength. Styled on the Camelot knights of days past, they're headed once more unto the breach. For there are whispers of angels beneath this hallowed land, a curtain of illusion and intrigue, a puppeteer behind the scene. Only one thing is certain. Those who take the road to Westminster will be forever changed. Because in mankind's pursuit of power, there is no price too high, no life too valuable, and no ideal too sacred. Because war, war never changes.
Mind the gap. Mind the gap. Stand clear of the door, please.
Subject has been performing adequately. No spikes in visuals. Nothing unusual.
Perfectly usual.
Quite. Smythe will be pleased.
How are they in appearance?
Uncertain. Perhaps we should take a closer examination. Excellent. A rapid progress is being made. And with zero anomaly.
Of course. Now, what about their physical and mental development?
Gentlemen, I trust everything is going well.
Tremendously so. In fact, it may be our best work yet.
Good. The subject looks ready for conditioning. Within a week or so, we can wrap up phase one.
I'll set phase one on autopilot.
See that it's done.
Seems to be rousing a bit.
Not to worry. Let's put them back under.
your power, the bloody thing you all caught.
Good morning, Connor. You won't use this in a public lock. Winston, you have power.
You got it, boss. Uh-huh. Yeah, no power. I can remove it from the main network. But...
what the fuck's that on the camera? Right outside, look. It may one of the floors.
I don't give a fuck. Just get us out of here. They'll have to find their own way.
Rerouting to emergency power.
Where are you going? I doubt you'll make it far, someone such as yourself. You were more useful as a lab rat.
Warning, warning, warning.
But alas, it seems I'm not long for this world. It's a shame, really. There was so much I wanted to do. Off you go, then. Me seeing you.
Emergency decontamination in effect.
You are quite the wayfarer, aren't you? Escaping all that hubbub with all you've been through. I'm impressed. It seems I neglected to introduce myself. Very unprofessional of me. I'm Ms. Smythe. And you? Well, it doesn't matter who you are. I'm sure you have many questions, and perhaps someday I'll answer them. But for now, wayfarer, let's not stand on parade. Since I'm all for giving one a sporting chance, I've unlocked the doors. Go. Stay safe, and remember, mind the gap.
Lobby. Rah! Bloody hell, what was that?
Sounded painful, if you ask me.
Better not be those dogs up to something. I swear if it is.
Not everything's the dogs, Johnny.
You look like shit, miss. You alright?
This one just came off the train, boss.
Quiet, the both of you. Well, well, well. If it isn't the lab rat, you made it out. You're in the right state, ain't you? Never had a crash round here before. Of course, Winston.
Here, enjoy.
Name's Gaunt. Sebastian Gaunt. And these dredges are Chill Winston and Johnny Shrapnel. But you can ignore Johnny. We're the Vagabonds.
We're the roughest, toughest, sharpest gang round these parts. Not like the dogs.
Snuff it, Johnny. Don't scare away our new acquaintance. So, who are you exactly? Only the gentry use those trains. Looks like you're a wayfarer now, like the rest of us. Yeah, well, you don't look like it. Lewisham, or what's left of it.
The
Isle of Dogs Syndicate. Johnny gets a bit excited about him. Yeah, he was supposed to be a supply run.
We bought the location off someone in Thameshaven. Some old construction papers.
Well then, Wayfarer. Seems like you got two choices. You could head down that way to the Thames folk. Ain't exactly pleasant to look at, but appearances can be deceiving. They may even know a thing or two about that lab, seeing as they sold us the location. Otherwise, you can stick it out with me and my mates. We help you out, you help us out. How can I put this nicely? They look like chewing gum stamped into the pavement. Let's just say that we're not the only gang sniffing around London, and we need help dealing with the competition. Obviously, we'd give you a little pick-me-up first. Ace, we could use an extra pair of hands.
Here, take this for the road. Its best days are behind it.
Prime rabbit in the headlights situation, I'll give you a rundown of who's who in old Blighty, shall I? First up, there's us. We're the Vagabonds. Used to be big names in South London till a couple of things went awry. But enough about that till later. The cunts who made things go awry are the Isle of Dogs Syndicate. There's a fucking lot of them, and they all walk around with the gentry reserves in their skyrocket, so they got tickets to burn. They got that bees and honey dancing with the gentry. The gentry rule from their ivory towers, pissing off their pedestals from Westminster. Forget trying to get in there. Those gates are tighter than a duck's arse. Why are they so tight, you ask? Because they've got the Tommies to defend them. Powerful enough to take the peace, too stupid to keep it. Which means the occasional toe rags crop up and have a punt at Blighty leadership. This brings me to the dress-up factions. Take your pick. Camelot, the only Tin Man Knights in Wandsworth. Or if you fancy painting it black, you've the Fifth Column Tyrants in Tower Hamlets. Next on the list, you've the twats in the periphery. Hooligans that'll smack you. Beefeaters that'll eat you. Jack Tars will stick a cannon up your arse. Roundels in Hackney. Well, they keep to themselves unless you've got a thing against scooters. Miller's men are the slapheads over in Islington. Neighbouring next to them are the pistols in Camden who wants anarchy in the UK. All of that makes sense. So as life dictates, you should probably stick with us. Know what I mean? The rest you can work out yourself, because I'm tired of monologuing. But yeah, if they shoot at you, they ain't your mate. Guns are more common round here these days, ever since Enfield opened its doors to all and sundry. You'll need to keep your head down. You ain't in that test tube anymore, sunshine. Now, left, right, left, right. I think they call it walking.
Look where you're going. There it is, Greenwich Station. We've got a small camp across the road. The fuck? What? Ricky, what the fuck?
They attacked us. Took us by surprise.
How many?
Two or three IODs.
Fucking dogs. Fuck them all.
And what the fuck were they doing here?
They were... I feel faint.
Christ, you're pathetic. Wayfarer, get a first aid kit from Greenwich Station.
My mother wanted me to be a farmer, but I get my hands dirty in other ways.
You came back.
After the IODs ambushed us, I heard them talking. There's gonna be an attack on the Swan and Mitre. The second I managed to give Gaunt that information, he left me here. The Horseman left me to die.
Probably wanted to get rid of any reinforcements before the attack. The clever, I'll give him that. Gaunt's gone, and he was the one with the medical know-how. Don't suppose he could fix me up, I thought you knew what you were doing. Fuck. Go to the Swan and Mitre. Give them dogs hell. You got me, but not my boys.
never should have come.
Thank you. never wanted me to be a farmer, but I get my hands dirty in other ways. Careful where you tread, or you'll give me a reason to have fun.
Into I do after.
Oi, oi.
Someone there.
Looks like I found this.
Lads! You reckon the bastard? Go on, get out of here.
You're that fresh face Gaunt mentioned. Good. Listen up. We got hit hard just there, but we managed to kill or capture every attacker, except one. I noticed a scout hang back and leg it when things swung our way. If they're bringing back up from the Isle of Dogs, we could be toast. I need you to stop them. They look to be beelining for the comm station north of here. I've got someone to trip the power on it remotely, but that'll only hold them so long. Go snuff out the hornet before it brings back the nest. The scout was a young lass. Denim fatigue, spiky hair. Should be easy to spot. Now go. If you need medical attention, I can take a look at you. But I can't do miracles. And wipe those questions off your tongue. We've got no time for that.
Need help?
Can't say I've treated a survivor of a rail accident before. This'll be interesting. There. You were suffering from some kind of psychological distress, probably brought on by the crash. That remedy should do the trick. Just remember those breathing exercises.
More bodies getting shite done, never hurting.
Oi, what do you want? Shit, I don't want to die. Please, don't hurt me. I only joined the syndicate last week. I was just in it for the money. I never wanted to see no blood. Please, please let me live. I promise, I'll leave this gang shit behind. Legend! Open your eyes, you wally!
If you hang around, wouldn't hurt none. We need the numbers. Look where you're going.
You get them? Good. You seem efficient. I like that. Gaunt said to give you some tickets for your troubles. Here. You're really not from these ends, are you? Tube tickets, money, dosh, moolah. What we use for trade round here. It's the standard currency all over London. Over here is the Swan and Mitre, the most ancient pub in the whole of London. Us vagabonds have had our home here for decades, even through the toughest times. We have some other safe houses, but let's keep them hush for now. Follow me and I'll get you acquainted with our chiefs.
It's not just the loss of men. We're hurting for ammo and other supplies. They keep hitting us like this, and they'll win for attrition.
Fucking dogs. We should hit them back, right this minute.
Easy now. Something stupid like that is exactly what they want to provoke. We've got to keep our heads.
Sorry to interrupt, chaps. I brought that newcomer along.
I've got no time for the detritus right now. Nelson, find something useful for this one to do. The rest of you, scram! I need to go think.
Never mind what Gaunt says, sweetie. He's a hard one, but he's been through a lot, and he bears a lot on his shoulders. He's got a big heart, really. The Isle of Dogs Syndicate has hurt us all in different ways. Some have scars you can see, some have scars you don't see. Gaunt was hurt deep. Has been ever since both his parents died. Poor lad, he's a good boss. He cares a lot for all of us. He just don't always show it so well. I've got to go now, but stick around, sweetie. We're good people when you get to know us.
Boy, newcomer. I think I still hear you breathing over there. Come over here and we'll have a gob.
Jill Winston said they fished you out some lab down the Pinder. If I still had eyes, I'd say you were pulling the wool over him. But Gaunt backed him up, and he's not the fanciful type. Well, pleased to meet you, Wayfarer. My name's Blind Nelson. I'm Sebastian's right-hand man, and I was the same to his father back when he was the boss of the Vagabonds. I can't see no more, but I've been round the houses far longer than anyone else here, and my brain still ticks as good as ever. Well, check out the eyes on this one. Yeah, there's a bunch of us commuters about. Something to do with radiation and whatnot. I never much cared why. I lost my skin to it back when I was young, and I've stayed like this ever since. You get used to it. There are some what call us ghouls. Cheeky bastards. We keep the order around Bromley. Stop the hooligans, keep businesses protected, manage goods in and out, that sort of thing. We're popular with the locals, which is more than you can say for most gangs around London. Times are hard, though. We're at war with the Isle of Dogs, and they've got more men and more guns than us. Simple fact is, my radio's broke, and I'm lost without it. Sebastian keeps me around for what brains I have, but without my radio, I'm deprived of some very necessary intel. I need someone with a pair of eyes and a pair of legs to fix it. You fit the bill, right? Here's the broken radio. Go find Chill Winston and ask him if he has any parts to fix it. Bullettooth Anthony has a workbench for when you got the bits. Bring it back here when it's all working smoothly and you're done. Easy, right? My mother wanted me to be a farmer, but I get my hands dirty in other ways.
Hello, mate. Nice to see you again. What can I do you for? I'm quartermaster. I try to keep supplies topped up, keep things running smoothly. Not easy, you know, but I make sure we get by. Why, we're the loveliest group of lads and lasses you'll find around any part of London. We're not loonies running around pretending to be knights, and we're not posh trash trying to lord it over everyone. We stand up for the little people, and we keep our neighbourhoods safe. What more could you ask for? They're squared up in Canary Wharf, acting all Ponzi-like. Bunch of clowns, if you ask me. But they're also our sworn enemies, and a lot of the cause of our supply shortages. I keep telling the lads, shoot your bullets accurately for a dog skull, and you'll have more bullets left for more dogs. Everyone's happy then. He's the boss, enough said. Oh, hey, let's have a butcher's. Looks like he needs a new antenna. I'll have one in a box somewhere, I'm sure. But look, whilst I'm rooting around for that, I've got a job for you. One of my main suppliers is running late with a delivery, and she's never late. I'm worried something's gone wrong, but after the latest attack here, I can't leave my post to see. I want you to nip down to Nadia's on Deptford High Street to check in on things, and get me the package if it's ready. By the time you're back, I'll have the antenna for you.
More bodies getting shite done never hurt anything.
I guess I have you to thank. Those hooligans were ruining my lovely shop. What a mess. Oh, yes. Good old vagabonds looking after us measly shopkeepers. Us poor lowly dealers subject to the whims and terrors of fate. We're very grateful, we are. Well, I have that Winston Fellows package here. Take it to him, will you? My usual runner got scared off and now I've got some clear up to do. But listen here, I am grateful to you for helping out. You need some supplies? I will give you the best prices. All ethically sourced, of course.
Thank you. could have just run.
Me,
you're dead.
Keep doing this forever. One last job, then I'll call it quits.
Huh? You're in shit.
Over here!
The fuck was that? Scared? You should be. Only a fucking coward hides. Yeah, keep running. Noise.
You.
There you
just
are, you
die.
Come on out. I'll make it nice and quick. Trust me.
Oh, been shook up over nothing.
Only a fucking coward hides. Yeah,
hey.
Keep running. The hell was that?
Thank you.
fire!
Eventually.
bodies getting shite done never hurt anything.
You got the delivery then? Thanks for that. And I'm glad Nadia's okay. She's one of my sharpest suppliers. I found the part for the radio you were after. Here you are. If you need a workbench to fix it, check with Bullettooth Anthony. He's usually down the basement.
If you hang around, it wouldn't hurt none. We need the numbers.
Hello, Sunshine. The name's Bullettooth Anthony. What you after? I fix up weapons, do repairs and maintenance. That sort of thing. We're the best brutes in Bromley. Won't find better than us. If we can get us some more weapons, we'll be a proper force to be reckoned with. I always say, the only good dog is a dead dog. Those syndicate buggers have a lot to answer for. You don't need to know more than that. He has it hard, Gaunt, but he's tough and he's fair as he needs to be. No chance, Sunshine. I'm trying to fix up an old laser rifle I found, and it's laid out in 100 pieces right now. You dare mess that up, and I'll have your head off. But look, you find me a piece to replace an old crystalline photon agitator, and I'll be able to finish it off. Then the workbench is all yours. Most messes of old scrap electronics will have something useful in them. You can generally salvage them in old supply stores, or some of the traders in Lewisham should sell them. My mother wanted me to be a farmer, but I get my hands dirty in other ways.